Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Priyanka Bidla. Today we are going to discuss about network analysis by forward pass. This is the learning outcome. At the end of the session, students will be able to appraise, means you have to evaluate the early start and the early finish date for the project. These are the contents of this video lecture. Then we see adding the time dimensions. This method requires to estimate the duration of each activity. For that, we have an estimate of its duration. And then the network is analyzed by carrying out a forward pass and the backward pass. From this, we understand how the calculations are carried out and how to interpret the results correctly. And then understand the limitations of the project also. There are the two methods, forward pass method and the backward pass method. So, forward pass is used to calculate earliest start and the earliest finish date. So, earliest start date is calculated with the help of this formula, that is earliest finish of the preceding activity. And earliest start plus activity duration is nothing but this is the earliest finish date. So, with the help of this, means we have to, with the help of forward pass, you have to calculate the earliest dates. Then backward pass, it is used to calculate the latest dates, that is latest start date and latest end date for the activities. Now moving towards to forward pass, you have to recall how to labeling to an activity node. Now pause the video for a minute and you have to recall how to labeling to an activity node. Then we see the labeling conventions here. First, take a rectangle. This rectangle is divided into two parts horizontally. Again, these two lines are divided into two parts. Then this rectangle is divided into two parts vertically. Again, this is divided into two parts. Then give the names. So middle one is nothing but this is the activity description. Then the remaining parts you have to give the names. This is the activity label, this is the duration, then this is activity span, and then float. And these four are nothing but the forward pass and the backward pass. Means with the help of forward pass, you have to calculate the earliest start and the earliest finish date. And with the help of backward pass, you have to calculate the latest start and the latest finish date. So we see the definitions of each. So first is the activity description. Here we have to describe the activity in short. Then activity label, give the label to an activity. Then duration, write down the duration of particular activity. Then these are the earliest start and the earliest finish date. These are nothing but these are the earliest dates for activity. Means what? It is the expected dates of the activity. And latest start, latest finish are nothing but these are actual latest dates, actual start date and the finish date of an activity. Activity span, it is expected span taken by the activity. Then float is nothing but it is a delay time to start the activity. Consider an example. Here you are assigned a project outline and it consists of 8 activities whose duration have been estimated. Then how long does the project take? We see with the help of next. That is, this table represents estimated activity duration of a project. So these are nothing but these are the activities. This is are the activity description. Then these are the duration and these are the precedents. So here A, B and F having no precedent. The meaning of these A, B and F start immediately. And the remaining activities, that is C, D, E, G and H having different precedents. The meaning of this, C having the A precedent, the meaning of this, whenever A has finished, then C can start. Like that, for G and H, there are the two precedents. The meaning of this, when E and F have been completed, then only we can start the G activity. So we see that there are the three activities, that is nothing but these activities having no precedent. So they will start immediately, right? So here we have to write down the activity level, and here we have to write down the duration of particular activity. So this is the activity A, this is activity B, and this is activity F. A, B and F having no precedent, so they will start immediately. Then the next C activity. For activity C, there is a precedent. The meaning of this, whenever A has finished, the activity C will start. Then the next D activity. D has the B precedent. So, do the connection. Then the same, E also B having the B precedent. So again, it is connected with the help of B. Next is the G activity. So for G activity, there are the two precedents, E and F. The meaning of this, when E and F completed, then G will start. So do the connection. Then H having C and D precedents. So again, connect with the help of C and D. Then after completion of H and G, the project is finished. So we have to write down finish. So this is the start, this is the finish. Then the next. Here we have to calculate the forward pass. Forward pass is used to calculate the earliest start and the earliest finish date. So this is earliest start date and this is the earliest finish date. So you have to write down A, B and F. These activities are immediate activities, right? So you have to write down directly 0 here. Here also 0 and here also 0. Means they are not having the precedent. So they will start immediately, right? This is the earliest start. Then calculate the earliest finish date. So earliest start plus duration, we get the earliest finish, 6. Then 0 plus 4, here we get 4. Then 0 plus 10, we get the 10. Then the activity C, here the 6 is write down as it is. So 6 plus 3, 9. Then 4 is write down here. Then 4 plus 4, here we get 8. Then here for E, B is the precedent. So 4 is written here. Then 4 plus 3, here we get the 7. The next G activity. For G, E and F are the precedent. But here for E requires 7 weeks, for F requires 10 weeks. So after completion of E and F, the G will start. So which is larger, you have to write down as it is. So 10 is the larger number, so write down as it is. Then again 10 plus 3, we get 13. Again for H, C and D are the precedents. Which is larger, write down as it is. So 9 is larger number, so write down. Then 9 plus 2, here we get 11, right? So after 11 and 13, means after completion of G and H, the project is finished. But here, for completion of project, we require the 13 weeks because 13 is the larger number, right? So in this way, we have to calculate the forward pass. These are the references. Thank you.